is the hadith of the 12 caliphs. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that this, the wording is لا يزال هذا الدين عزيزا منيعا إلى إثني عشر خليفة. This religion shall stay aziz, glorious, until there shall be 12 successors. إثني عشر خليفة. The question would be, is this a reference to the 12 khulafa, caliphs, that have existed throughout the history of Islam sporadically in separate times? For instance, you had the first four khalifas and then Sayyidina Imam Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu, this making five. And the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we also say Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, this making six. You have Umar bin Abdul Aziz, this makes seven. You have other pious khulafa. Not all of them were pious, but some of them were pious. In total, up to Al-Imam al-Mahdi, which will be the 12th, there are 12 khulafa which will, under whom the religion shall be mighty and strong. But if we interpret the hadith to mean that this hadith refers to the 12 imams of the Shia, then under Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq radiallahu anhu, Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq radiallahu anhu never took leadership. So the hadith cannot apply to Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq radiallahu anhu, because the hadith is referring to 12 rulers, people who actually rule. It will apply on Sayyiduna Ali and Sayyiduna Al-Imam al-Hasan radiallahu anhuma, because they ruled. But this hadith, if you look at all the narrations of this same hadith, you will find that the hadith is referring to a khalifa who shall rule, not to someone who did not rule. So the 12 imams, not all of them have ruled. From Sayyiduna al-Imam al-Hussain radiallahu anhu up to the 12th imam. Of course, the identity of Sayyiduna al-Imam al-Mahdi, according to Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, is that he is a leader who shall be born in the end of times. The Shia, on the other hand, say he is someone in occultation in a cave. He's in a cave currently. Now this leads to other beliefs of the Shia. See, on Al-Imama again, they have other beliefs like Al-Raj'a. What is the belief of Al-Raj'a? What they believe regarding Al-Raj'a is that because the 12 Imams, not all of them ruled as they should have ruled, like Sayyiduna Ali radiallahu anhu, his rule was for 6 years, but his rule was during civil war. So they believe the souls of the Imams shall go back into their bodies and they shall come back. This belief is known as the belief of Al-Raj'a. That toward the end of times, when Al-Imam Al-Mahdi radiallahu anhu shall appear, the Imams shall also appear with him in order to support him. So for proof of this, they give the story of Ashabul Kahf, the story of the people of the cave. They give different proof for this. But the reason for this belief, if you go back, you will realize is Al-Imama. Again, every issue will always go back to Al-Imama. Until they do not prove Al-Imama, the whole belief system of Shiaism will fall apart.